We are at Bitcoin 2025, and I wanted to use this opportunity to tell you very quickly about Tether, but not many people know all the ways Tether as a company is supporting Bitcoin. So this is one of my preferred images because, see, you just need to ask nicely and then, you know, things will be given. All right, so I like this one because it shows like how I feel about Bitcoin is Goku, and well, I was born in the 80s, so Dragon Ball was a big part of my youth, and 90s, and we are Vegeta, right? It's friend. It's a less powerful friend, but a very helpful friend during the journey of Bitcoin. Tether is a company that started from nothing in 2014. Is a company that created the first stablecoin, USDT. The slide is slightly outdated because this morning we crossed $153 billion, so I had to give the slides 2 days ago. Thank you. But something that I really like is the fact that before I was talking about, in a fireside chat, I was talking about this moment, basically. This moment when the pandemic happened. So during the journey of Tether USDT, so this is when Tether was only used for cryptocurrency trading. This is the pandemic, and this is basically the growth of USDT during the pandemic times. Because from being just a product used for cryptocurrency trading became the dollar for hundreds of millions of people. And since from 2020 to 2022, we didn't even have a marketing team. So I wish I could claim that growth was done because we were perfect, great, did advertisement. We didn't nothing about that. Actually, all happened because when you create a product that actually people need, it will just grow by itself and through the word of mouth. Some statistics. Last year, we made 13 billion in profits. We keep 120 billion plus in US treasuries as of now. We committed to reinvest a lot into Bitcoin. We are going to see it in a little bit. But we have now more than 100,000 Bitcoin that we own as a company. Thank you. We have around 50 tons of gold. Many Bitcoiners don't like gold, and maybe this is going to be controversial, but many Bitcoiners don't like talking about gold as if gold would take away something from Bitcoin. There is no way. Bitcoin is perfect, gold is imperfect. Thank you. But the reality is that Bitcoin is money governed by math, and gold is not competing with Bitcoin, but gold is competing with fiat. So that's why we like a little bit of gold, because just we believe that in the future, gold will represent the natural Bitcoin in a certain way. I know that people think about Bitcoin as the digital gold. I think that I prefer to think in Bitcoin terms, and I think gold is kind of a resource of nature and is almost like the natural Bitcoin. We have 420 million users in emerging markets in developing countries. We are growing at a huge pace. We represent 62% of all decentralized exchange volumes with USDT. And one of the most beautiful statistics that also is referred to the chart that I was displaying before is that 35% of the users of USDT are using USDT as a saving account, right? Because they live in countries like Turkey, Argentina, Vietnam, where the devaluation of their national currency is so huge that they need to actually, they prefer to use the dollar rather than their national currency, and they use it for savings. How I feel about Tether, right? Tether is a company that is in high contrast with traditional big tech companies and traditional finance. I created this short sentence, death by 1,000 intermediaries. I believe that in finance and in big tech, we have too many intermediaries. In finance, these intermediaries are milking fees from every single financial transactions that we do in our lives. In tech, we have these big tech companies that are custodying not our money, but are custodying our data. And that, in my opinion, is the same thing. We are not self-sovereign as humans, as communities, as families, and as cities, as nations, if we don't have both control over our money and control over our data. So that's why when I think about Tether, the role of Tether is coming up with solutions, technology, and tools that will remove as many intermediaries as possible from the equation, from our lives. We are a company that was born with Bitcoin. We are all Bitcoiners at heart. Everyone in our company loves Bitcoin. That's why this talk today, we are, I think, built different. First of all, we have our headquarters in El Salvador, the original Bitcoin country. We support El Salvador. We believe it's the most beautiful country in the world. It has huge opportunity. It has a great story. For 20 years, the country was disrupted by the pandillas, by the gangs. The president has showed a very high courage, has demonstrated that politicians, if they really want to change things, they have all the opportunities to do so. And I'm seeing the same thing now in the United States. The United States has decided to turn the page and start to understand how important Bitcoin is for the world, for its own country. And you can see it quickly in just few weeks, few months, the result is astonishing. So again, politicians can actually do things. I'm sorry, I'm Italian, I'm not used to that. So one of the things that at Tether we are very proud of, as I said before, we have more than 100,000 Bitcoin in our treasury. By the way, the addresses are public, so we are not hiding that. I think it's very, very, very important. Thank you. USDT is coming to Lightning. We announced that in Plan B El Salvador. I believe that Lightning is the perfect, or Lightning-like channels are the perfect solution for scaling transactions and payments. Today, I was reading a research from Castle Islands that was saying that USDT is 80% of all the payments volume in the digital asset industry. That is astonishing. But my problem is that all the layer twos on every single altcoin chain are not scalable. They are suffering from one big problem. It's called single share state. And instead, when you have a layer twos like Lightning that have peer-to-peer channels, the thing is completely different. They can scale to trillions of users. Of course, you know, they need maybe some adjustments, some tweaks, but the logic is there, the opportunity is there, and that's the right way to build this technology. If you want to scale, you cannot use single share states, you have to use peer-to-peer channels. We invested $2 billion in energy production and Bitcoin mining. Actually, it's a bit more than that. Something that you know, we have been very shy to say it, but I think that is very realistic about that by the end of this year, Tether will be the biggest Bitcoin miner in the world, even including all the public companies. Thank you. So some people ask us, why the hell you are doing Bitcoin mining if you have, and you have, you can just buy Bitcoin, you have 100,000 Bitcoin in your company. Right, why you're doing Bitcoin mining. And I believe that it's very important to do Bitcoin mining because exactly that is the hedge. That is our protection for our Bitcoin treasury is actually participating to the security of the Bitcoin mining network itself. WDK is an open source wallet development kit so that we can start building consumer apps, consumer wallets, but also every company, every app, every website, every AI agent can have a non-custodial Bitcoin wallet built in. So when I read about some, you know, Bitcoin or wallet libraries anyway that ask you to input an API key to interact with a custody service, I don't believe AI agents will want or should use an API key to connect to a custody, an external custody system. I want my AI agent to have a non-custodial wallet so I can grant him some money. The money is kept by the AI agent, and the AI agent will work for me. Will not work under the rules and conditions on someone else. That's something that I think if we want this technology to be helpful to us and not being helpful to the corporates, then it's how it should be. We need to be sovereign when it comes to money and when it comes to data and when it comes to intelligence. Speaking about intelligence, we have announced our AI platform recently. It's called QVAC. The name is taken from The Last Question, that is a beautiful short story, it's 14 pages, written by Isaac Asimov in 1956. I recommend everyone to read it. The ultimate question, the last question, is how may we reverse entropy in the universe? We started building a peer-to-peer AI platform that does local inference on any device, even smartwatches, can scale to any device, $30 smartphones for Africa, any flagship phone, any laptop, any mainframe server, and all that. And we believe it's the right approach to try to create an AI system, an intelligent and infinite intelligence system that is actually helpful for society and not for corporates that are going to milk your data and take your data, become super rich with your data, and give nothing back to you. That is a company that is run by John Carvalho, is Bitcoin first company, building Bitcoin first tools. 21, we talk about it. Jack Mallers is the CEO. Cantor, Tether, SoftBank. It's a beautiful fellowship. I'm a big fan also of The Lord of the Rings, so I'd like to call it that. This is Giacomo Zucco. He probably does not know that I have him on this slide. So Tether also invested and is the biggest backer of the Plan B network. Plan B is, I was told that in the US, Plan B means something else. I think it's a great brand that means that everyone should have a Plan B in case the Plan A fails. And what we want to teach with the Plan B educational initiative is the fact that you need to have tools, monetary tools, hence Bitcoin, and technological tools, hence peer-to-peer connectivity and telecommunication technology, in case everything around you fails you, right? I hate the fact that money and technology is built for the best case scenario, while we want money and technology that will help us in the moment we need it the most, that is the worst case scenario. We drive Bitcoin education with universities. We partner with tens of different universities and to drive Bitcoin education. Recently, we announced our second grant to support BTC Pay Server. That is an open source project that handles Bitcoin payments. It's a great one. I really recommend everyone to use it. We have been entering a partnership with our brand, with our collaboration with the Lugano seat in Switzerland, where we have a boutique conference called Plan B. We enter in collaboration also with the Lugano Football Club so that we can bring the Bitcoin brand to every single football match in Europe. We have launched with Fulgur a Plan B fund, a venture fund, to invest in Bitcoin startups. Through our great friends and partners at Rumble, Tether invested $775 million in Rumble. They have a Bitcoin treasury themselves. We are collaborating to launch a Rumble wallet that will be a Bitcoin first and a little bit of stablecoins wallet for the people. Not for geeks and nerds only, but for the people that need to approach the first time the usage of Bitcoin. Kit is our, thank you. Kit is our peer-to-peer communication app. It's still in alpha mode, but is the proof that you can do very high-scale peer-to-peer telecommunications with voice, chat, whatever. There is a great Bitcoin chat channel with thousands of people and tens of millions of messages and videos, photos, audio messages, all shared in this chat across these thousands of people without any central server. So that is the living proof that cloud is not our friend, is something that was told us, imposed on us, and is just there as an illusion to milk our data. Thank you very much. I know that I took a bit more time, but I really appreciate. Very grateful to be here with you in the United States. See you.